नमस्कार, स्वागत छ दर्शकवृन्द यहाँहरूलाई कार्यक्रम छ प्रश्नमा। छ प्रश्नको आजकै श्रृङ्खलामा म रोहन श्रेष्ठ छु र आज हामी कुराकानी गर्न गइरहेका छौँ भर्खरै मात्रै नेपालमा बुद्ध मूर्ति ल्याइएको अवस्था रहेको छ, जो त्यो पनि लुम्बिनी गार्डन फाउन्डेसन स्पेनको अग्रसरतामा ल्याइएको अवस्था रहेको छ, जसलाई चाहिँ लुम्बिनी इन्टरनेसनल एयरपोर्टमा लगेर प्रतिस्थापन गरिँदैछ। यसै सेरोफेरोमा रहेर आज हामी त्यो विचारका प्रवर्तक, अझ भन्नुपर्दाखेरि लुम्बिनी स्पेनबाट बुद्धको मूर्तिलाई नेपाल ल्याएर प्रतिस्थापन गर्ने सोच जसले बनाउनु भएको छ अथवा जुन फाउन्डेसनले यसको नेतृत्व लिइरहेको छ, त्यही फाउन्डेसनका प्रेसिडेन्टसँग आज हामी कुराकानी गर्न गइरहेका छौँ। त्यसको लागि आज हामीसँग हाम्रो स्टुडियोमा होसे म्यानुएल भिलानोभा हुनुहुन्छ र उहाँ प्रेसिडेन्ट हुनुहुन्छ लुम्बिनी गार्डन फाउन्डेसनका। उहाँलाई स्वागत गरौँ। वेलकम टु नेपाल, वेलकम टु न्युज 24 टेलिभिजन।
नमस्कार, गुड मर्निङ न्युज 24, गुड मर्निङ नेपाल।
नमस्कार, इट्स प्लेजर टु यु नो ह्याभ यु हियर इन दिस स्टुडियो।
थ्याङ्क यू सो मच, फर्स्ट टाइम फर मी टु बी हियर इन दिस स्टुडियो। आइ एम सो ह्याप्पी द्याट यु गिभ मी दिस अपर्चुनिटी।
इज दिस द फर्स्ट टाइम इन नेपाल?
टाइम आई अराइभ इन नेपाल वाज इन आई थिंक 1999 or 2000, ऑलरेडी मोर देन 20 इयर्स।
टू डिकेड्स, इजन्ट इट?
या।
सो वाट इज योर एक्सपीरियन्स विथ नेपाल?
ब्यूटिफुल, अन्टिल नाउ आई एम स्टिल हियर, कमिङ एभ्री इयर। Okay. It's like, for me, it's my second house. I hope when I get retired to live here.
Can you please highlight something on this visit of yours? Why did you come to Nepal with the specific purpose you are here? Can you please highlight that?
We are very happy. You know, Lumbini Gada Foundation, which is a Nepal and Spanish foundation. We are so happy to be here to receive the White Jade Buddha. Coming to Lumbini, mm-hmm. to the birthplace of Lord Buddha, that will be set up in the international airport, in the new international airport of Lumbini.
Lumbini International Airport.
Yeah, right. So we came here and we are ready to receive the Spanish delegation arriving on October 28th.
Okay.
As a president of assembly of one of the most important regions of Spain. Also the mayor of Cáceres, which is the city which is have a sister city with Lumbini. Both are World Heritage Cities. Mm-hmm. They are coming with a big delegation of
Cáceres, isn't it? In Cáceres. The Cáceres itself, that Lumbini Garden Foundation is?
Yes, this is where we are going to build the Lumbini Garden project. Is different temples from Asia.
Cáceres, in the city of Cáceres.
Yeah, Cáceres is one of the oldest city in Europe. It was created by the Roman Empire before Jesus Christ.
Okay.
And is a very interesting city.
Yes, that's quite interesting, isn't it? Because Spain itself is a Christian country, isn't it?
Yes.
Catholic, especially, Catholic, since you belong to the same community. Yeah, so how come this Cáceres, as the sister city of Lumbini, it's quite interesting. There's a huge question mark. How come, isn't it?
Well, Spain is a very open-minded country. Mm-hmm. Cáceres is the oldest city in Europe since more than 2,000 years. Jews, Christian, and Muslim philosophies of life, religions are established there. Mm-hmm. So with this project, with this sister city in between Lumbini and Cáceres, we are bringing Buddhism to join with other three main religions. This is a nice heritage for our country.
Cáceres.
Yeah, okay. And it's a nice project to receive Buddhism in this old city of Spain.
Mm-hmm. Tell us something about the project that you are going to implement in Nepal. Why?
Well, Lumbini is recently building the new international
airport.
And I'm totally sure they will have millions of visitors coming from all over the world. Mm-hmm. As Lumbini is a World Heritage City too, you know?
Right.
So we are sending this Buddha to Lumbini just to pay respect and honor to the birthplace of Buddha. So this is a symbol of peace for the whole world. And the Lumbini Gada Foundation is sending this beautiful White Jade Buddha that is already here in Nepal. And we need to find a place, a nice place to show to everyone. Mm-hmm. And as this international airport is an open place, it is going to be very well visited by many people. You know, there is a very safety area in between the two pavilions, protected by a crystal and security. So the Buddha, we found out that this is a beautiful place so everyone can see. Every visitor coming to Lumbini will realize that the city, this city is having a sister city with Cáceres, and that in Cáceres there is a building, the High Buddha, the, which is a replica of the small one, is going to be here in Lumbini.
It will be of 2 meter height, isn't it?
The one in Lumbini is 2 meters high. The one is going to be built in Cáceres, no, it's 66. It's going to be the...
Made of the same, isn't it? White jet.
Yeah, yeah, white jet is going to be the tallest sitting Buddha in the world.
Mm-hmm. 66 meter high.
66 meters high. This is more or less like the Statue of Liberty. This Buddha, the meaning of this Buddha is to become a beacon of peace to the whole world. You know, Spain is the motherland of America, South America, Central America, and many countries in North America. Mm-hmm. Also is in the core of a European continent and facing Africa. So from this strategic position, we can spread the Buddhism philosophy to the whole world coming from Nepal. Spain is receiving, before pandemic, we received 87 million visitors. We are the second largest country with income tourism, you know, mm-hmm. in the world.
Yeah. So it's how the idea emerged, you know, of sending this white jet Buddha to Nepal, that too in the Lumbini International Airport.
Well, the main idea is to create a bridge in between East and West. This bridge of peace, bridge of ahimsa. The world is living really uncertain moments after mm-hmm. this pandemic, and we are in a very unstable moment of the history. So more than now, the world needs a change of consciousness. We found out that the world message of peace coming from Lord Buddha and from Nepal is a beautiful project to show the world, you know, that the world needs to change. We need to change in between humans. No need too much egos and greedies and selfies. We need more compassion, mm-hmm. we need more helping each other, you know. We need to care about climate change. We need to care about the development of the poorest country. We need to care about the human rights. We need to care about human, woman rights, children's rights. All this make us more compassion, you know. And Buddha's philosophy is a perfect philosophy to explain this, you know. Mm-hmm. So with this project, you know, we want to show the world that the planet did a change of consciousness. Mm-hmm. And the best way of doing this is to build a big symbol of peace.
We can make a Catholic Christian. How come you got, you know, inclination towards this Buddhism?
Well, after being many years in Nepal, mm-hmm. I found out more about Buddhism, and little by little I realized there is a very realistic philosophy, you know. There is not God. There is not God. So if there is not God, there is not violence, you know. Christians, Muslims, Jews, we fight because there is a God. And we kill many people because there is a God. It's, when you have a God, you have a big, big fight, you know, because you need to say, no, my God is the truth one, or no, my God is the truth mm-hmm. one. So you see, Buddhism has not a God. Buddhism talk about the human being, you know. Buddhism is a doctrine to show that every human being can be enlightened, and every if we see inside us and we look for our inner peace, you know, we can become very nice persons and we can help to change the consciousness of the world, you know. So this idea of humans, this idea of everyone can be a Buddha, this really is more realistic than changing thinking that there is a heaven or hell or other things, you know. So new generations are more identified more with these ideas of Buddha, you know, and we think it's a nice message coming from this philosophy of life, because this is a philosophy of life that was established in Nepal already more than 2,500 years ago. So I think it's a good moment to show the world that we need to change. We need to be really more compassive. We need to help the weakest people, you know. We need to help our planet. You need, this is absolutely necessary, absolutely necessary. And this project is just a symbol. It's a beacon of peace, showing the world that the big message of peace is coming from Nepal to the whole world.
Do you think that this project is going to flourish the philosophy of Buddhism worldwide, or just between Nepal and Spain?
Of course, already happening.
In
you
what
know,
way?
Yeah, Spain and Nepal has the first meetings on 1968. Mm-hmm. The King of Spain, I think, traveled to Nepal, and
the Nepalese King went to
but
Spain.
But since then, nothing happened. Now we start this project, and Spain and Nepal has a high relation in between both countries. A few months ago, Upper House President Mr. Ganesh Tinoxina visited Spain, invited by the President of the Spanish Senate, mayors of Lumbini, Debda, Kapilavastu, Rangram, the holy cities. They came to Spain and they signed different agreements with the Cáceres city. Also, different businessmen delegations has come to work on development. You know, if there is no peace, there is no development. So, and now this high.
So this project will not only focus on the spreading the flourishment of this Buddhism philosophy.
Yeah, this is a very transversal project. Of course, focus on the spiritual issue, but this project is also a cultural project. This project is also an international cooperation project in between countries and help development project, because when we have friendship, if we are good friends, we can do things. If we are not friends, we do nothing. So the Buddha is in the middle, providing peace to all of us in order to exchange culture, exchange languages, exchange knowledge. This is the idea. Spain can help a lot to Nepal to be developed, and Nepal can help a lot to Spain in many other issues. We have parallel histories, you know.
So can we say that this will be the starting point?
This is the starting point of a beautiful project that is already happening. And the main sample that this is happening is that this Buddha arrived to Lumbini already.
That's the positive thing, isn't it?
It's very positive. Has not been easy at all to send this Buddha to Nepal.
Well, it is said that it's very difficult to work in Nepal. So what is your thought on it? Is it really very difficult to bring such a huge project in Nepal, or the political parties are very much cooperative to for this kind of issues?
Well, maybe because
what is your experience on that?
I feel very comfortable here. Well, mainly because I have a very strong team, our Spanish, Nepalese team are three Nepalese men, very, very working hard. Is Nira Shrestha Dai, Govinda Subedi Bai, and Ekra Kiri Bai. They are my brothers. They are helping me a lot to achieve my commitments here in Nepal. Without them, this cannot be possible.
What of the support of the government, the political party, the mayors of the concerned places?
Oh, they all love this idea. I talk with all the political main actors here, and they all support. They all support. They like the idea. Well, it's a beautiful idea. You know, Nepal has one of the most valuable icons in the world, which is Lord Buddha. Nepal, with this project, can send a powerful message to the whole world. So Nepal should be feel proud about this, because having such a beautiful project, you know, and all politicians help and support us. Of course, things has to go step by step because things are not easy. But you see, we start 4 years ago. 4 years ago, we have nothing, and after 4 years, we have done many things. We have not only this project, but also many other countries joining us, joining this project from Nepal.
Which countries?
Well, Thailand.
Okay.
Sri Lanka, China, Myanmar, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, Bhutan. Today, Bhutan received one replica of the Buddha of Lumbini.
Similar kind.
One. There are 15 Buddhas, like the one in Nepal, coming in Lumbini, 15. No, sorry, 16. Why 16? Because 16 arahats, one for each Buddhist country, or generally Buddhist main doctrine, and one for Spain. The Buddha of Spain and the Buddha of Lumbini are linked through a sister city, signed by both World Heritage Cities. And the rest of the countries are the Dharma, where long time ago Ashoka spread the Buddhism.
Right.
Now the Dharma is coming back to Nepal. It's coming back to Lumbini. And from Lumbini, we'll go to the Western countries. It's a beautiful story happening.
Right. We will hear about this story, but it's time for short commercial break. We will be right back after this short commercial break. दर्शन पुनः स्वागत छ यहाँहरुलाई कार्यक्रम 6 प्रश्नमा आज हामीसँग हुनुहुन्छ होस इमानुएल विलानोभा र उहाँ एकजना त्यस्ता पात्र बन्नु भएको छ पछिल्लो समय जसले चाहिँ नेपालमा जन्मेका गौतम बुद्धको ती लेसनहरू ती चाहिँ उहाँले दिनुभएका मार्ग दृष्टान्त ती सिद्धान्तहरूलाई विश्वभरि नै प्रचार गर्नको लागि एउटा अहम भूमिका यति बेला चाहिँ निर्वाह गरिरहनु भएको छ र त्यसको सूत्रपात भनेर चाहिँ हामीले लुम्बिनी इन्टरनेसनल एयरपोर्टमा पछिल्लो समय राख्न खोजिएको बुद्धको विषयमा हामी आज हामी कुराकानी गरिरहेका छौँ र यसै विषयमा थप कुराकानी गर्नको लागि हामी फेरि पनि उहाँसँग चाहिँ जोडिँदैछौँ र उहाँ हुनुहुन्छ लुम्बिनी गार्डन फाउन्डेसनका प्रेजिडेन्ट होसे म्यानुएल विलानोभा. Welcome once again.
Thank you so much.
You're just talking about this story. There's a beautiful story connected with this project. Can you please highlight something on this? How can the world come together for the flourishment of Buddhism, for the flourishment of the teachings by Lord Gautam Buddha?
Well, I think that the main issue is that we need to change our mind. We cannot feel we cannot be so much close to attachments. Mm-hmm. The world is have a big ego, you know. We are all, this is all increasing economy, working hard, money and money and money. And on this career, we are losing many values. Mm-hmm. We can see after pandemic what is happening.
This, right.
This COVID pandemic has been a disaster, disaster. Rich people are richer than ever. Poor people are poorer than ever.
There's a gap between the rich and the poor.
This cannot be this way. This cannot be this way. You know, we come to the world to be happy.
How come this monetary value get attached with this?
Well, in some way,
Buddha's preachings.
In some way, Buddhism help people to be calm.
Right.
To know more about
not to worry.
Not to worry. To, you know, everything is relative, you know. We are here for a short period of time. We're a drop of water in the ocean. Mm-hmm. We all will die soon, you know, because life is so short. So during this period of transit, it is better to make good things than bad things, you know, and to be compassionate, to help people. Mm-hmm. I think bring more happiness than being selfish or having big attachments or big egos, you know. When you are in this type of statement, you really suffer more. You really suffer more. So the meaning of this project is to help people to be to discover through Buddhism the inner peace, the metta sutta, the loving compassion towards others, you know, because the world needs it. Mm-hmm. More than ever.
Why the world has not been able to understand the teachings of Lord Gautam Buddha, including Nepal? Because in Nepal, as the birthplace of Gautam Buddha, Nepal itself has not been able to spread the masses. Even we have not been able to follow the path shown by Gautam Buddha. Forget about the rest of the world, they say.
Well, something curious is happening that really make me think a lot. You see, for example, now in Western countries, we are losing richness, mm-hmm. but we are gaining spirituality.
Richness in a sense?
There are more poor people. Mm-hmm. There are more gap in between poor and rich. And Asia is becoming more rich, but losing spirituality.
So European country, it's heading towards attaining the spiritual goal.
Right.
Can you say that?
Yes, we can say that.
In what way?
Materialistic things are not important at all. we since we wake up until we go to sleep, we are always thinking on this. This has no sense. If you stop for a while and you clean your mind, mm-hmm. You will find out that, of course, we have to work. Life is this way, you know.
But we need money, isn't it?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, but we don't need to be such much ambitious. You know, that 90% of the richness of this country, of the wealth of this country, is in the 1% of the population. Mm. This is not justice. This is not fair. We need to change this. How we change it? The only way is to change our mind. There is no other ways. We cannot pretend to change big corporations. They will never change. The only way to change this is we change our mind. If we change our mind, we can change the people around and the society. This is the only way. That's why Buddhism, it is the right doctrine to help people to change the mind, you know, because you look inside yourself. You're looking for the best of you. And Buddhism show you that we are good, we are all good people. Only circumstances around are changing us. So why not? Why not give importance to this doctrine of life? Why not impulse such a beautiful project like the Lumbini Garden Project coming from Nepal to the whole world? Mm-hmm. Why not? You know, I'm almost 60 years old. I've been working all my life for surviving, business. Now, at this time of my age, I want to do something different. I want to do something I feel comfortable with, you know? And I love this idea.
What is the actual need of life? Is it the materialistic thing or the salvation? Or spiritual satisfaction?
It helped me a lot on my way of thinking, okay. Being more good people, good person, not being so ambitious, seeing life with more calm, with the experience I have on my life. Now I found out that many things are not so much important, and others that I didn't pay too much attention during my life are really important. And this project is helping me a lot to change my way of seeing life and being as a
person. The way of thinking.
Yeah, right.
The perception, isn't it? Buddhism for you, is it the philosophy or the religion?
Well, it's a doctrine of life, for sure.
Because in Nepal, people grant it as the religion, isn't it?
Well, I don't think it's a religion. Well, let me explain to you. During the life of Buddha, religion didn't exist. Didn't exist. Religion start later on, you know, and the different tendencies like Mahayana, Theravada,
different streams
came later on. You know, when Buddha was born, right. And during his life, it was just a way of a man who was trying to understand why the suffering of the people, try to understand how to avoid suffering, and he was enlightened. Mm-hmm. And he find out that our sufferings are coming because attachments. So we are focusing on this. We don't care. I mean, we don't want to be so much involved in the religions because it's difficult to understand, you know, different tendencies, different ways of thinking. We also, of course, accept it because this is an inclusive project. But we want to focus on the man, on the human being, on his history, which is linked to Nepal and to Lumbini. This is what we really care more about.
Mm-hmm. So that is the foremost thing, isn't it? So how can Nepal and Spain come together to flourish the preachings of Lord Gautam Buddha? How can we join hands together?
Well, they are already doing it. They have signed different agreements. Now there is a Spanish delegation coming on 28. There are going to be some agreements signed in between Nepal and Spain. And this will have consequences in Europe. Spain also will promote Nepal and Lumbini, birthplace of Buddha, all around Europe. And when hopefully soon this pandemic is over and we can go back to normal life and tourism start growing again, there will be many tourists coming from Spain to
Nepal.
To Nepal for sure.
What is the major motto of, you know, establishing such a kind of Buddhist root, I must say, isn't it? Putting the Lumbini in the center and spreading the Dharma across the world.
Well, you know, the idea, as I told you, is that Dharma comes from the different Buddhist countries to Nepal again, okay? Like Korea, Japan, China, all these countries I mentioned before, okay? And then from Lumbini can be exported to the Western countries. So it's all a big chain that it has to work together, you know, to export loving compassion with a high level, you know? We need the support and the help of all the Buddhist countries on behalf of this project of Nepal, you know? And Spain and Europe and Western countries has to receive the best of the Dharma coming from Asia. That's the reason that's why there are many countries involved, and this is a big role all over all these countries, you know?
Including Sri Lanka, Thailand, and many more, isn't it? Myanmar.
Yeah, all of them, yes.
Tell us something about this white jade. It is regarded as a precious stone, isn't it?
Oh, it is indeed.
So is a crystal. What is the actual cost? Can I ask you the actual cost of this, you know, crafting the Gautam Buddha? with this school.
I know this is a big issue now.
Right.
It's a big issue. For me, this statue has no value. Has no value. If we go only to the value of the market, well, it's very easy. We can go to Hong Kong market or Shanghai market. We can see the value of the grain of white jade is around in between 10 to 12 euros per grain. Mm-hmm. This is 2 tons of white jade in one piece. That means 2 millions. 2 millions on grain. So let's say this is in between 15 to 20 million euros value. But the value is higher. The value is higher. This white jade is coming from one specific place in Myanmar, Mandalay. Mm-hmm. Mandalay, Wanchen Mountains. Lord Buddha himself visited on the 5th century before Jesus Christ this place. And he declared himself white jade as a spiritual stone. White jade is a precious stone. It's a pyroxen, crystal of pyroxen. Mm-hmm. It's almost crystal. It has a very high spiritual value. It brings you calm.
Right.
It has big value in China's Chinese culture. Since thousands of years ago, you know, the emperors of the old China used the white jade as a coin. It also bring you more health, lucky, and more loving compassion. And that's the meaning. That's why we want to build the Buddha on white jade, because we need to show on the world a shining icon of loving compassion. Uh-huh. So this only can be done with a very high level material. Mm-hmm. And it's not easy to find. There are only 2 types of jades. One is nephrite, the other is jadeite. Jadeite is only, you can only find in Myanmar. Mm-hmm. No, there is no other place. And it is very expensive, yes it is.
At last, if you want to say something to our audience.
That you have a beautiful country.
Thank you so really much for that.
You should feel very proud of Nepal. You have the ceiling of the world. You have the Mount Everest and the high Himalayan mountains, but you also have Lord Buddha.
Right.
You have the Ahimsa message for the whole world. And I hope so. I talk to many people. Yeah, they feel proud about this. And sometimes it's not easy to do things, you know.
Right.
Uh-huh. And sometimes when you are inside the country, you cannot see things like if you are outside, you know. Because when you are inside, very nearby, you are involved in your normal problems every day, and then you don't focus so much, you know, because you have it very near you. But when you are outside and you see the forest, you know, from outside, you can say, my God, Nepal has such a powerful icon, which is the ambassador of peace. It's the best ambassador of peace in
right.
the world.
Uh-huh.
So it's time. It's time for Nepal to promote around the world with this big icon of peace.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Jose, for coming to our studio and giving your verdict. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for that. This is me, Anna Bandhir. Thank you very much. I'm going to stop you. Here's the Ron Hola, News 24 Television. Namaskar.